Hey, good morning. Hello, hi, good morning.
Hi, good morning. This is Anil.
Hey, good morning. This is Chiranjeev.
Hello, this is Raj.
Hear me? Hello? Can you hear me? Hello?
Yes, we can hear you.
Okay. Okay, let me go. Okay. Okay. So, good morning, everyone. So, the main course agenda is why BPC is needed for customers and what is the advantage with BPC. Hi guys, my name is Gurvi Reddy. I have a total 16 years of experience in BW and BPC and ABAP. And I'm more in BW initially. Right now, last 8 years, I was in full in BPC. Previously also I worked in IP projects and like planning. And I worked across the globe, around 30 projects in BW and BPC with ABAP. And the course of BPC is like why BPC is needed for the customers and what are the key components are there and what is the help of with HANA and how the planning is happen and like you know that there is what is the advantage of ADS4 in the planning compared to other info providers which was there in earlier and how the data acquisition solutions like planning scenarios like we have a planning is how you are doing like you know previous year suppose we have a previous year plan data previous year forecast data and previous year 5 years planning data and you copy that and do the allocation for certain areas like you know 5% 10% trend how you are allocating to them and how you are distributing to equally for each year and there are like copy there are some calculations like you enter quantity and price as a total price you enter cost and quantity you get the cost of goods and like that you will get to the all the calculations not only that there are various calculations discount and promotions various types of that and how that the formulas are you know using inverse formulas and planning buffer is there once you enter the data it's saving in the database there is some time that is called planning buffer how the BPC portal like there is a see there are planning tools are plenty in the world why people prefer is BPCs there is a workflow there is a called planning owner planning manager planning functional head there will be workflow will be there like approval mechanism workflow you know that step by step activity to perform the step by step activity is meaning like you enter plan data your manager will approve your manager will review approve or review or accept or he will send back to you again there is a certain like a certain limit manager also can modify it and forward to functional head there are ways are there so based on that your planning will be aware of entire your key team like you means our owner and our manager and his manager total boss head the functional headwind. So that is, it is going like a step by step, like the planning process. And there is audit. Suppose there is audit. If you have a data planning data is there, you have a audit. So the audit will take care. Like, you know, how you will, how you did the planning process, like how you changed, how much you had it, how much remark was there, how much comments. The audit comments also there. Suppose the owner and manager and functional head, there are the planning process, what was there, that will be including your comments, like information what you did, it will be updated. So that will be there. And that is why the BPC is so popular. So there is a, you know, embedded BPC. Previously only BPC was there. Only you can, you know, you can load the data. Previously you can load also with EPM. Now it is not like that. So whatever the BW consultant was doing from almost 20 years. I was from BW almost working. Only one version I was not worked. That is called 1.0A, 1.0B. Rest of all versions I also worked. That version, from there, the whatever BW experience guys can work on BPC, that embedded BPC. They have, at least they can contribute and work can be done at least like, you know, 40 to 50%. That is in embedded BPC. If you doesn't know BW also, there is a one more is classic BPC. There you create objects, but backend BW backend objects will develop. But that you cannot do anything with that BW. You cannot, you know, for just monitor for a backend, what was the data loaded for something, you know, some light optimizer, full optimizer. There are some performance tuning things. Those only you can do with that, the BW backends for classic BPC. But embedded BPC means it can be done anything in BW. You can load it, you can create master data, you can manipulate everything. And with that, via this portal, you can come here. You can come and, you know, you can manage. If there is an environment, suppose let's consider this. So I'll show you. Once you do the objects and BW objects, BW models, and after that there is a planning models, tools will be there. Once you do that, you can create a, this is a models also you can create with the, we can link with the BW modeling objects with BPC models. This is a classic. This is a classic BPC, and BW model planning objects and classic BPC planning model objects, you can combine and create a work status audit and BPC security. That will be become your embedded BPC. Basically, these are the planning models. Okay, suppose you are in planning. Okay, this is still it is showing that. These are the dimensions. Suppose there is a one backend cube will be there. So see what is there in the planning account, audit trail, category, entity, intercompany partner, product, a reporting currency type. This is for something like different. This non-contours. See, there are some models. There will be backend. There is a queue. Suppose we have a generated one info provider. So that will link here. And on this ADSO or what is the info provider, you can create a planning queries and whatever it is. You can access via BPFs and all. That I'll tell you. So step by step. So there are some process also there. So once you come here, there will be BPF, business process flows. The process flows I told you, there is a work status will be there. The work status, there is a owner will enter and his manager will review it and reset or confirm or approve it, and functionality he will move it. He will approve according to that. That is called work status. Based on all work status you will create how the work. For each model there will be one work status. Model means like we know that model. There is a sales planning is one model. Cost center planning is one model. Operational OPEX planning is one model. Financial planning is one model. There are ways of different business. Project planning is there. Sales planning is there. Whatever the planning is, just like, to avoid the losses and to improve your business profits and to unnecessary expenditure. And not only that, it will be everything to, the relationship between you and customer. And it will be satisfies everything. On time you deliver, on time you will do the, response to the customers. And you will plan based on customer requirement. And you will supply accordingly. And you will satisfy the customer accordingly. Suppose there is a customer relationship as well. They give the mobile something, okay? You tell that will take in 2 hours, but you will tell to repair and all. What you will do, you will say 6 hours. Before that, you will complete it and ready. Then the customer is came and you given, customer will happy. Or else you just taken the a mobile and you said 2 hours, but you put him in 4 hours, he will disappoint. So such kind of things you will avoid with the plan. And there are something, okay? Suppose there is a requirement to, there is a manufacturing you need to supply 200 tons, but you originally you plan for the 250, but suddenly the customer is a change. So based on he cannot able to sell it, is the sales office he have requested and he did something I don't know, because suddenly he said I don't know, business is happening like this, so can you reduce? Suddenly you change. And then what you will do, so you have done more, like you manufactured 50 tons more. So it will be loss for us, and the warehouse where you will put, you don't know. So what you will do, the next planning will be there, correct? The immediate planning, other same material, same people, somebody will demand. Whoever demanded already, whoever planned it, there you will adjust. You will adjust for this customer. That is called forecasting. So you expect something delivery, but customer not ready to take. So you will not fight with customer, correct? He paying money and he ordered, but he is not taking. So such kind of things also can be handled with this planning forecasting. One is a budgeting, other one is a forecasting. And prior to that is previous year actuals. All this we need to compare it with the system. How you are handling the actuals, we know that, whereas we have operations. We have a different operations, a different legacy systems like SAP, non-SAP, and ERPs are different systems that will be there. Based on you will consider all together into one system, that is called BW. So the BW will be the key for the PPC planning. So the embedded PPC is, I told you there is a BW consultant can handle the PPC means, that is embedded PPC. There is a one more PPC called optimized. Optimized BPC can handle more with the help of functional. See, there is so much configuration. That is, you no need to load data. Data will sit in a ECC S4 finance system. You can analyze the reports with the virtual BW. Virtual BW means it is you created providers like virtual info providers, models and all. On top of that, you can build models, planning models. Based on those models, you can, without loading the data, you can do. But this embedded BW only, purely BW based PPC. Even classic also, it is not. Classic, just to create authors, and you load data via EPM, and you create models from this. You just create a models from here, some planning or whatever it is. You create from here a consultation or planning. And I told you what is a consultation and planning. One more thing, I'll explain in the next topic. So you can create different models like sales planning, different planning, cost center, OPEX. There are fixed asset planning and plant maintenance order planning. There are new technologies came, but some people used to PM orders planning as well. And there are different other like, you know, different planning areas like sales segment, market segments. Segments, you know that, group of mass data combination called segments. Like, you know, customer is there, customer groups is there, and customer sales app is there. There are, you can combine together into one segment. You can keep into one combination into, suppose you create a one segment in DSO or mass data. So you can link with them, the combination. The group is called segment. You can make the planning in the segment level. What is the benefit you do segment level? Suppose you do segment level, it will multiple customers are there, customer groups are there, sales office there. You will identify with that segment. This segment goes to that. Top down and bottom down. Top down means your segment. Bottom down means customer group, customer sales office. Like that, it will distribute. That is called top down and bottom. So that planning can be done in this BDC. So based on your segment grouping and all. So it's not only that, we have discussed what is a consultation. Consultation is another, is a big topic. It's a fully, there is a consultation, we are not in scope actually. What is a consultation? Consultation, I told you, various business actual operation you will consider. You will consider and you will convert into your, suppose you are in head office, okay? Like your organization or entity, parent and child, there is a relationship. Okay, parent company, child company. Parent company is the owner, child is sub companies. That is called parent company called headquarters. Okay, child companies, there are like, you know, divisions, like different offices, something like. So there you need to know that that operations will be in different countries, different places in same country, and you will be there. If it is the same country, there is no need to do any currency translation because it's the same currency. If it is a different country and there will be some different currencies, you need to get into local currency. That is called headquarter currency. That is also called as a reporting currency. So that you will handle. You will get that. And why? What are the things needed? First one is, so suppose there is a company to company sales is there. So that is called intercompany. So you will club together, you add two amounts in the, suppose you pay it and that guy will receive. But it is going any in a, on a one account, correct? That transactions you need to report. Okay, that is a one. Suppose there is a different country, child company, and then you know you need to currency translation, and there is a ownership there. I'll tell you, there is a headquarter company is one having more shares, and there is a, because every company, there is every country, there is a different rules. Okay, you will not able to directly go and establish the company. So there you will be having difficulties to maintain also without local owner relationship or something. Then you will go local and give partnership, and you spend more money, but you will give more ownership to the local people, something like different. All the things will be handled in the system. You will calculate the ownership values. And once you calculate the ownership values, you create a financial statement. This is the owner is getting this much, this is the owner this much is getting. And you will create a report. Here we are spending, there we are profit and loss, where is the income, where is our fixed assets, where is our balance sheet. That's called balance sheet. Profit and loss, balance sheet, financial statement, reports should be created. That is called concern. These two things can be handled, and one more thing is planning and forecasting. It's not only planning, forecast and budgeting. Budgeting is called as planning. Forecast is just like, you know, based on situation you are adjusting, that's called forecast. Okay, and coming to that. Okay, that models I told you, master data, and all you want to see master data. Suppose this is a, see, wherever this two combination is nothing but dimensions, nothing but evaluation, business evaluation fields. it's indicator for the anything to do planning or to do business. Suppose you don't know the planning, you don't know, see, we suppose you are entering business data. What is this? And how do you identify certain dimensions? You will correct. So when you are purchasing some plot, what you will think, you need certain dimensions, 30 centimeters, 40 width, 30 length, some kind of dimensions we need. That is called, that will tell what is dimensions. Similar like here also, there is a category. The category identify the version. Version means certain period validity. What is the rolling planning period? And what is the end period? And what year it is? That will tell based on your category. The category is a key in the planning. And the time. Time is like what is the period and year. And what is the fiscal year? The fiscal year errant is nothing but your factory calendar. What is the start period? What is the end period? What are the days? Suppose we have a different periods, like we have a month, January 31st, February 28th, March 31st, April 30th, May 31st, June 30th. How you identify? So based on that is American calendar you will tell. And similarly, you do for your factory. You have your own factory, you are your own organism. You will split according to you need. That is called fiscal errant. So you will put all that. So the category will tell what is the, which version, which model, which year, which period. It's related to what is a rolling start. See, any planning, suppose you do planning, basically you do not do planning for the start period. Very rarely they do. But really, when you go real time or when you go customer, the seasonal planning called crop planning. Suppose you are depending on some crop or some season, like, you know, depends on, suppose market season or festival season, you do planning. That is called seasonal. And suppose there is some raw material which is with farming lands you are getting, like a tobacco or some rice or something. That time what you will do? You will identify what is the crop start, cropping, like brown, I mean like last stage. When we are doing rice farming, when it will come, we know that in India there are different places, different timings. So that is called crop year. So crop period, crop year and crop period. So based on that crop year and crop period, you will identify when it is come. Seasonal, when is the festival come, when it goes, then you will identify based on all that. You know that January 1st you will get so many festivals, and January to April we will get a lot of festivals. After that, we'll get very less festivals, like depends on that. So we'll calculate all of that and get that. You will identify the what is the start period, what is the end period. You will get those information, and that is will be taken care in the category and this periods, and the rest is what you needed, material I needed. Customer, what customer information I needed. What is the country? What is the sales office? What is the reason? So something like you will get some information. Okay, what is the category? What is the unit? Like you taking material, you want in tons. You want in kgs. Like you can split units as well. So that is called dimensions. Once you have a dimensions, so in BW you will create a models, models with input orders that I'm sure. So that I will tell you. So we need to log in that as well. How it will work? How that looks? Actually, what most of the objects will be created in Ana Studio, and very minimal objects will log in from this. This is the SAP login. And this is HANA. So most of the objects you will create from this. And once you created, I'll show you some objects. Once you create a planning object, there is a planning tool is there. So you can, these are the planning objects. BW info providers, nothing but ADSO. And aggregation levels. Aggregation level will help you to link from BW info provider and input query. Planning, you will enter some data that will taken care with aggregation level. Filters, you know that. Filter means suppose there are 12 countries and 20 materials, you want to two countries, 10 materials, you can filter. Planning function, I told you. There is a planning function, copy, calculations, and distribute. There are some, you know, file load, there are plenty options are there. That planning functions will take. Planning sequence, step by step. First, we have to copy plan. And then owner will enter and change some planning and allocate some values and do the some calculations that can be done with the planning functions and the sequence combination. So there is some RFC failed. Okay, that will tell later. Okay, it's not a thing. And suppose let's see, there are some aggregation level, how that looks. So it should be created in ANA only. So here we have taken time characteristics and category and dimensions like cost center and GLM. This is called cost center planning. The cost center will tell different users will assign different cost center. The GL account tell type of expenses like transport expenses or furniture expenses, like operational expenses, like headcount expenses, like salary wages expenses, different expenses will all together operational planning. Any organization you go, basically first needed is cost center plan. Entire organization, we have so much budget we need to pay the raw contractors and transports. So different, like furniture, chairs, phones, snacks, tea, coffee, cafeteria expenses, like warehouse expenses. All expenses will come into the combination of that will tell the GL account, and cost center tells where it is. The location will tell. The cost center will tell. So particular, there are two offices or three offices are there. The cost center will tell for this is for this office, this this is this conference room, and this is cafeteria, this fourth floor cafeteria, third floor cafeteria, ninth floor printer, 10th floor printer, like different. And this expenses for plant location, this plant location USA, this is a plant location UK, like different things. We'll come into that and we'll tell that. So that will identifies based on all that. And also, this I told you, amount is called budget. Suppose some quantity also you can add, and you can add units, like here it is a fixed unit will be there, maybe you can add, like we can this will any questions? Hello.
Instructor, why don't you introduce yourself? I think we are jumping onto the content right away. I have other questions too, like how much is the work we going to do in BW and BPC, and also explain, like I have an IP background, integrated planning and BW. I designed a couple of planning scenarios and planning models. So how close it is, like if I know IP, what is the delta to learn this? Okay. And also,
if you know IP, yeah, very good. You, if you are in IP, you know BW as well, correct?
That's correct.
So, yeah, the delta is, what is AMDP? AMDP also, did you aware of it? I don't think so.
No, AMBP, what is that?
Above data managed procedures. And you, if you are a functional consultant or technical?
Both.
Okay. So if you are in both, that ABAPR will write. Okay. And you need to know what is advantage.
I want to give you an update. Like I do not, my system is not on HANA. We are just upgraded to BW 7.5. It's a regular conventional database only, not on HANA.
Okay. So in that case, see, if you are not in HANA, you know that Fox also, you know. So once you know
Fox,
IP, you
know Fox that. I know.
Okay. Once you come with BW 7.5 and with 10.1 and embedded BPC, I have told you there is a workflow, audit mechanism, BPFs, instance, step-by-step activities, audit reporting, BPC security, and that is your delta, beginning delta. And when you come into the next stage, like B4 HANA, this is a B4 HANA. This is completely on BW. Okay, B4 HANA means completely B4 with full HANA based. It is like there is no statical BW object. Suppose there is some HANA is there, even some HANA BW 7.5, 7.4. When you migrate from BW static BW 7.3, 7.4 into BW HANA, you don't need to have to convert, migrate into HANA objects, fully in-memory objects. But when you come into BW4 HANA, it's completely IMO, in memory optimized. The performance like zigzag, you click and you should get. So, but they will tell like that HANA, but it will not happen. But compared to other database models, it will be quicker. Not only HANA, there are some other in memory tools are there, almost 10, but we are using SAP, correct? We should go ahead.
Okay. Yeah. Basically, so attending this session or training session, after completing this session or training, total training, would I able to do a BPC embedded planning models, and can I able to build based on my scenario like BW 7.5 on conventional database and 10.1 BPC?
Yeah, you can create, but the only thing is, the objects which you are doing there, the planning cube, Okay, planning ADS, real-time ADS4 was you are creating. Here, what you need to create, planning ADS4. There is a ADS4 has come. ADS4
okay.
You need to create. You know already how to create ADS4s. ADS4 facility is having more keys. Like, you know, you can combine a cube, DS4, master data, everything into one. And with 120 key pins.
Okay. So BW side, little bit changes there between HANA and 7.5, but on the BPC side, activity is common, right?
Your IP things is common. I can say IP is a common, and analysis office also you are not aware of it, correct?
No.
That is a main. The key is analysis office. The analysis office will, you know, you can enter the plan data and you will integrate a button so you can trigger a planning functions. What you will do previously with BW only, you log into that BW RS plan and planning sequence you trigger, correct?
Mm-hmm.
In the IP. But here you will not. Here you will click the, you create a analysis for office. And planning sequences, planning functions integrate with analysis office that you link into the workflow, the work status you are creating. Like owner enter the plan, manager review it, function head also will review on top of that. That work status you will create, and that work status you will include into BPF workflow will include. That workflow instance and activities you perform by your whoever performer, whoever reviewer, they will be reviewed and they will be performing. That is a difference between IP and BPC.
Analysis for office, I think it's a Bob J suit, right?
Correct. Business object new tool, and it's a purely Excel based. There you can. You create a planning query, you know that, Bex query,
yeah,
same planning query. That planning query you will include here, and you put some macro buttons like copy, refresh, prompts, re-enter that, and delete plan data, and recalculate, and re-evaluate. There are some, you know, calculations are there, turnover, costs, some planning calculations you will split in and perform step by step.
Okay.
And once you click everything, the buttons, once you click that, it will calculate automatically via triggering your planning functions, planning sequences.
So you won't be using EPM at all, right? You won't be using EPM tool at all?
EPM, yes. In the BPC 11, the advantage of BPC 11 is you can suppose you create something in classic, same thing in BPC portal is there, correct?
Mm-hmm.
The portal which I showed, there are also you can create a planning models. I have told you, you can create our with the classic model if you are there. Okay, suppose you have a classic model objects and you created some models that you can create a EPM. Suppose you created embedded model.
I got it, that one. But with embedded one, are you going to create an EPM or not?
That's what. Embedded, once you link with this model, with the environment, you can create. You can create a input forms and all.
In EPM, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, you can.
Or else analysis for office.
Yeah, best practice is analysis for office. EPM is performance is bad. And you will get input forms and work status. There is just work status completed.
One more question. Since I am on 7.5, 10.1 in BPC, can I use the analyzer, Bex analyzer?
Yes.
I know. Huh?
Yes, you can. Bex analyzer is a key, and there are one more ASCA, okay, SAP planning, cloud, SAP analytic cloud. Did you aware of it?
Yeah, I'm little bit aware of it. SAP
Yeah.
Analytics.
What is that? Is suppose you created a ADSO planning, ADSO you created, you will link with the cloud system. There, live connection, that's called live connection. You no need to load data, you no need to create a planning query also. So there you drag and drop, you create a planning stories. And the data will store in PWQ and planning will be done in SAC. It will happen. That is called SAC planning. So without planning, the BEX queries, you can create a planning.
What you that call what it is? What it is?
Live connection. With the live connection.
What you call, what is what's planning in SEC?
SAC, cloud planning, SAC. SAC analytic cloud, SAP analytic cloud planning.
SAC, okay, SAC, yeah, okay, SAP, SAC planning, okay.
SAC means SAP analytic cloud. Okay. There, you know that you have to create a BEX query. You create a top in the bottom, planning ADSO. With live connection, you can create a connection with BW, that is called hybrid. Even if you have a model, you create an environment model, correct? Head. This model, we are having model. With this model, you can access this is a plan, correct? Suppose if we need this model, you can also integrate with the BPC model. There also you can create a planning stories. You can update data into BW directly. There you no need to create a BEX queries. That's called hybrid planning.
So couple of ways, right? You, as I understood, you can running on BW 7.5 on a conventional database. You can activate the embedded and you can call the cube and aggregation into PPC side environment. And you can embed it into planning side and you can use a EPM tool or BPC.
It's optional. It is BPC. Optional. Yes. That's called, I'll tell you, it is optional either you are going in ANA or, BW for ANA. There are five types of BPC, five plus SAC, six, I can say. Let me explain about BPC versions. The Microsoft version is there. It's a purely not BW based, Oracle based, SQL based tables will be there. That's called Microsoft. In that also Microsoft Edge version, that is also same, that is called cloud. You can use the database. That is cloud. You forget about that. Then you coming to the BW network version with BPC, and which you are working with IP. Similar same. Backend will be same. But the way of activity, the BPC model, which you need to learn the data, like work status, models, and auditing, all this. That is come with BW network. Even you are a static model, okay, BW model. So there you will link with that, but performance will be not good. That is the difference. That is called, that is also embedded BPC without HANA. Okay, that also you can do. But only the difference is performance. You will struggle with time. Like suppose some reports will run 20 minutes, 30 minutes as well. Some reports also will stop, hang out. Okay, dump will give. And
My IP is running very fast. I mean, I don't see that many that much time at all.
I'll tell you, you will think like that, but it happens. You may, which type of industry you are.
I'm into high tech, semiconductor industry.
Semiconductor also somehow some decent customers, correct? Semiconductors means like customers are less, correct? you will you in the, your sales data use. Are you aware of that?
Yeah. I have
so it. I also worked statue pack. My Singapore first ECC 5i only word in Asia in stats semiconductor. So their sales data is issues. Other across other business, I may not think is more correct.
Yeah.
Am I correct?
What did you say? Sorry.
Sales data will be more.
Yes, sales data and marketing forecast, sales forecast. That's what we do.
There, data will be more. Morely, you will be in COPA planning. And later on, you came into sales planning in the business. Correct?
Yeah, there is no COPA. We are not using just a simple like sales data, you know, comparing the forecast versus actuals and all, you know.
Correct. So at least that same thing can be handled in COPA, but COPA, what is the disadvantage? COPA, you can enter one transaction level, like one sales order, one customer level you open and you manage it. But yeah. BPC, why you need to come? You can enter multiple at a time. So your that is the difference between BPC planning and other you know financial. Integrated business planning, SAP integrated business planning.
Yeah.
So BPC will enter, can enter multiple customers, multiple orders. You can enter at a time, items and all. That is the difference. So in your say semiconductor, may if you are in planning, you are doing planning only, correct? Planning you will also split by your user. There is a security will restrict by your users, correct?
That's correct.
That is why you will get less. You will be based on your segment level, you will get data. That will be done. So some calculations will require a complex hardware, correct? Those scenarios it will be for the HANA.
Okay.
I can agree if we are creating proper models, there is no dependence in the master data and all, you will get some performance in BW come. Why BW came in into picture is for performance reason compared to others.
Yeah. Okay.
Like there are 16 dimensions, we have one fact table, one compression on top of fact table also, we have to delete zeros, minus plus transactions and all. To get cumulative values, consolidation values, you are getting that in the compression. So all that will be having good performance in BW compared to other. HANA become the drawback of BW performance. So that is why they're using HANA.
And, okay. Can you please share your contact number so that I have other doubts also? I don't know. There would be some other attendees might have some other questions. So I think I will pass on to them. Please share your number.
You can talk to Rajendra, whatever doubts, maybe we can discuss. You have a Rajendra number, correct?
I don't know. I do not have anybody's number. I can reach out to tech, whatever the source.
You reach out. You reach it to him, and the next session will explain you whenever you have a doubt. Not a problem. The doubts I will be.
I do want to discuss offline. Probably you know, it may not be applicable to other attendees, right? So okay. Just pass your number so that I can contact you offline, and we can discuss. I want to judge how this is going to help me.
No, it will definitely help you. I'll tell you, there is a only, okay, I'm typing my number, okay.
Hi, Instructor, I have a question too. Can I ask you now?
Yeah, please.
Yeah, so I see a BPC 11.0 embedded. You're not going to touch base classic BPC, right?
Yes, we are going classic BPC, we are explaining. Like, basics, classic BPC models, I'll explain how okay. to create a classic BPC. Without classic BPC, will not go. Like okay. Data loading models, we are not explaining.
Yeah, let me tell my background. See, I do have BW and IP and analysis office. We did a project in Conagra Foods. I'm pretty much familiar with that. But the problem is, I'm not, if I say like an IP guy with BW, I'm not getting enough projects. So only if you have both, you know, a classic BPC and embedded BPC, that would, I think that makes more sense.
Now, that way I'll have more trend time. Is embedded BPC.
Exactly.
And embedded BPC means you will get your accept your data load. See, the future called old technology will be removed. Anybody whoever greenfield implementation or enhancement, if they are going with embedded BPC, because they will never go with suppose they upgraded, they have a existing business, they will keep with classic BPC. And people will start developing the aggregation levels. You know that, correct? ADSO, analysis for office. And the main thing is the what is called classic BPC. Embedded BPC means classic plus BW, IP. The classic, what is needed? You need to create a environment and model and work status and BPF. Audit trail mechanism, audit reports monitor, process monitor to close your planning period and all. And those things are important. That will be covered in security, BPC security. What it does, BW, you create some authorization object in backend and full authorization. The BPC security, how that works. BW give full authorization. When you come into the BPC, only this user can only read it and only display, only read it and write it. You create a access data access profile.
So
and task profile, that is common. You know task profile?
I don't know.
What is the task profile does? You have a limitation for this model and this environment, and that environment you will create. You have a models, so different models. You have a sales model. There are 30 models you have. You don't require all that, correct? So only you need to have provide access certain. And certain data access, DAPs. Data, you need to have only 10 or 20. So you will get them and you will restrict out and you will get that. That is what.
That's, so do we need to know about EPM as well, or we are not going to use EPM? We are going to use IAF4.
EPM,
right?
See that BPC 11 is combination of EPM and this. You can consolidation means better to you create a consolidation in a classic model. But people will prefer and do it, better to do it in embedded only with a newer version. Once you familiar, it will be, features will be very good.
So one
not
question.
Not familiar with all this. In one consolidation only, I'll tell you. There is a, in S4 real-time consolidation is there. And S4 group reporting is there. And classic BPC consolidation is there. And embedded BPC with both combination consolidation is there. There are plenty roadmaps are different from every day. The technologies is keep changing every day. And so if you are in one organization, you are in Conagra full-time employee in US or wherever, so you will follow that only that. When you are in software sector like IBM, TCS, Wipro, some kind of companies, you will be changing different projects, correct?
Yeah.
There you need to have all the skills. All the skills if you have, you can survive in market.
So, instructor, so on the content side, what are the components you are going to teach part of this training?
I have explained all that already. Okay. Basically, BW, aggregation levels, and security, like basic security, not full security, okay? And how the local and standalone global data, integrating the data, how you can combine multiple data. So I'm also explaining the small BW data loading, okay, and aggregation level. First ADSO master data I'll create, and I create custom master data some, because it's a playing system. You need to create manually all the data, okay? And so that is what we need to, first we need to create a dimensions or master data info objects and create a master data and ADSO aggregation level and planning input query, analysis for office and buttons with VB code. VB code, I will get it, and a similar code you will copy it, implement by your own. And that code and planning, I have told you, planning functions, planning sequences, filters, characteristic relationship, and data slices purpose. And then coming into the models and environment and linking that with analysis office and create a BPC workflows and everything. And in everything I'm showing, and I'm covering in 20 classes, including.
I have a couple of questions. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. So I'm from the BW4 background, and I don't have knowledge in the planning areas. Since really the other folks have the planning background, like I have zero knowledge in planning focused and budgeting. Are you going to cover a couple of sessions like where the planning is required for the company?
That I'm explaining. What are the dimensions needed? What is the business needed? I will be showing two models with the creating in the system class itself. And I will be explaining 4-6 or up to 10 models function scenarios, like how to create and all. That takes only 5 minutes per one. A functional explanation, actually, but the end-to-end development will be taking 3-4 days for one model. That right. I will now be creating two models in the system and doing that.
Yeah, in the starting of the session, like you mentioned, like
it will be helpful if you are ADSO composite providers and all, correct?
Yeah.
So master data
when you come to
that's enough. BigQuery, right. Then I'll take care. I'm explaining everything. BW, which is a required for BW, also I'm teaching some, not fully. So, okay.
Yeah.
It's a required.
Sure. BW. Like, yeah. I have one more question, please. Don't mind. When you come to the sales planning, why the sales planning is required for the company? And when we talk about the OPEX or the operational expenditure, on what basis it is going to be checked by the company or the capital expenditure. So these are the few things like I want to know the functionality I want to know.
The functionality I'll explain. Suppose we are in one electrical, this power generation company, and you are supplying power from long distance to some places. So instead of you are transporting and spending and to, you know, make the lines and giving power to there, if you have a power supplying from nearest location, you will not require to make lines and poles and do that, correct? So directly with the simple little distance, you will put poles and wires and you will supply the power. So for that, you will think about that. There are some requirement that area you are spending too much, so you will go and put there. The demand is there more. You will identify. You will put a capital investment. Similarly, there are banks. There are some competitor banks are there, and your bank is not there. So what you will think? You will find out some, you know, rental building. And the rental, which is available immediately, you will plan it. And how much required, employee strength is required, furniture is required, you plan it and do the capital expenditure. So these things will be getting. Suppose operational expenses, every year, every suppose March 31st is complete, means your budget will go away. You doesn't have any income, any money to for next year expenditures. For that, you will be, suppose if there is no planner, you will take, you need 2 rupees, you will take 10 rupees. Hey, I need 10 rupees, you will ask. Why you, but some, you know, the cash is not available. Due to that, you will face some challenges, correct? So everybody coming and taking unwanted money and taking huge money and spending unnecessarily, that will be create a problem in company, correct? There will be no discipline, no control and all, correct? Such kind of scenarios, you will plan it. So you will plan in earlier, you plan this, okay, we can allot this. You-
One request, like-
Yes, tell me.
Yeah, one request, like when you explain this thing, could you please open a spreadsheet and when you keep on it, like probably it can helpful to
sure we'll do that. Don't worry, we'll explain in one Excel what is the purpose, what is the use,
right.
And we'll in detail we'll get into that and we'll go more.
Okay, thanks. Yeah,
any others?
Hey trainer, I have a question. Anil here.
Yes,
since the technology is evolving, like, you know, we came from like 7.5, 10, 10.1 and 11 now, and the new version maybe launched or not, I don't know. So like how long we should keep updating ourselves, you know? The classic was like fine from 7 to 10.1, it was good. It was a very long years, and now embedded came into the picture. So SAP gonna implement more advanced technologies after embedded, like how long it gonna be last? Like, since I see the most of the projects in TCS, HCL and other Indian companies, they are running only 10.1, and the support of 10.1 till 2022, December 31st. So like embedded, like how long it gonna last? And how is the job market for the embedded?
That we cannot tell, because see, still I told you, I was working in BW2 version. Similarly, there are plenty companies continuing same, okay? And some of them 3X. Some of them, you know, the company is like, someone gentleman spoke to me, BW 7.5 also, IP also, performance is good. So it is, they are adjusting something, okay, whatever things are available, they are adjusting like that, there they will be. So whoever coming greenfield implementation, they are with going with the BPC 11. Why? The reason is because of BW for HANA. BW for HANA is having, I told you, SAC planning can be done with hybrid planning. Without Bex Query also, you can create a planning. And simply SAC planning can be done. And you don't need to spend too much time also. And that is the one feature. Everything in HANA is on feature. Performance, there are some features available here. You can create a, previously some text planning also, you are facing some so many things. So now you no need to do, just right click and cell, you can comment what purpose you are commenting and doing. And there are master data planning also. Suppose your dimensions or something master data, you have an incorrect there. That also you can do in the planning itself. You can swipe the master data. Some requirement they want to, suppose this is moved to some other plant. This material also is there in some other plant, and something, there are attributes. So that also you can swap here. There are features, good features are there in BW, BPC 11, and with the BW for HANA. And we have a flexible reporting hierarchy. There are some hierarchies also. You can, a local hierarchy, you can create a assigned plan, and that we could distribute. There are features came, And people are whoever going greenfield implementation, customer, suppose you are in market, like looking for a job, or you are in pre-sales consultant, like a freelancer. Okay, so even you are in, suppose you want to activities, you are in pre-sales activities in organization, then you need to know all this, correct? So that is why you need to learn. And greenfield implementation come, people will prefer with this 11 and 11 or more. And with the SAC also, they will go like that. So we cannot say that old one go away. So that support and all, they will stop. Like they stop APO, right? APO, they stop, they come with the IBP, like export planning. Something like they stop it, whoever new product, the selling the product will stop. The SAP, what they do, they will not sell that product, but whatever existing customers, they support. That is the difference.
So, trainer, do we need to learn this EPM for this BPC 11 embedded?
No need. We are not covering EPM. We are just focusing analysis for all this. Okay, EPM is purely based on, EPM also can be done, but it's a purely embedded BPC. So the EPM will work for, classic BPC objects, and this one will work for that.
Okay.
Everything is a new technology, new things is there. Why we need to go EPM? There is a performance low, performance less, and everything. Okay.
And just to confirm with you again, like if you are not running on Bob J, there is no analysis office. Can we use the analyzer, Beck's analyzer?
Yeah, we can use it. Okay. So almost session started 1.5 hours actually. Okay, we can. So quickly, I want to close it in 1 or 2 minutes. Quickly ask, okay? Any other questions? See, EPM, I told you, correct? EPM is a old one, and performance is not good. Why we need to go that? That's what I'm asking. If we are going in embedded, okay? The covering and all, if you want, I can. Right. Okay, it's not a big deal. Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. Anybody?
Yeah, just a request, like patient detail and spreadsheet, the Excel sheet, that would really help in understanding.
Yeah, definitely. Okay, while teaching, put in one Excel agenda. This is what this we will explain. We'll try to do that.
What okay. Is going to be covered. Yeah. Yeah. Thanks.
Yeah. So have a good day.
Trainer, one last question. Like, since I'm working in the classic version, I do not have much knowledge in BW side. So this course will help me.
Yeah. In the I'll BW. Help you. I'm expecting that BW also. This course is BW 25%, 50% IP with the combination, new BW objects, and 25% with the classic BPC.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Okay, have a good day. Any questions? Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you all. Thank you.